Okay, my friends, so here you have few questions on the screen. So that's my humble submission, first of all, to take a snap of it so that it will be there in your mobile phone and you will be able to see those questions whenever it would be required. Please take a snap of it. If you want me to zoom it further, I'm zooming it further. I guess the snap should be looking good now. You may take a screenshot of it. You may take a snap of it if you are right now in the laptop. Whatever the case, that may be visible to all of you. Okay, let's move ahead. Let me first brief you that what we had started last time around. My friends, we were there into the time value of money. We have understood the tremendous power of the compounding. We have understood that the compounding is the magic bullet. If you'll keep your money invested for a long period of time, it will give you tremendous amount of fruits after some period of time. The power of compounding is enormous. It's a fantabulous thing. The one who has understood the power of compounding will never be stuck in the money related matters. Now we will go to the practical exercises of the time value of money. There are various complications related to the time value of the money. It can be bifurcated into various parts. So just giving you the brief idea about the process of compounding and discounting. Try to understand. My friends, this compounding and discounting both can be interpreted from the loan perspective too, from the investment perspective too. So many of the students always get stuck that whether to use PVFV in the loan or whether to use PVFV in the investments, because loan is also something on which the interest gets compounded. If you do not pay the interest for one period, that will be there in your fund, that will be part of your liability now, and the next interest would be paid by you on the amount of loan taken plus the interest which is due for one period. So the same mechanism gets applied over there too. So basically there are two processes. One is the compounding process. In a compounding process, my friend, you want to reach to the future value, and here we have the present value. So you have some amount of money right now and you want to reach to the future value. Now this can be interpreted from the two perspectives. One is the investment, another one is the loan. So say if it is an investment. In investment, first you invest. So there is a cash outflow. And then you receive your money back. So then there is a cash inflow. But when you take a loan from someone, my friend, then the first one is the cash inflow because you receive the money, right? To utilize it somewhere for what you have taken the loan. And then you will pay the money after some period of time. That is the cash outflow. So only the order of cash inflow and the cash outflow gets changed. The dynamics and the formula remains. Because even if you take the loan, my friend, you are supposed to pay the money. Say you do not pay the money for one period. Obviously, for the next period, the interest will be part of your amount due, right? So the interest for the next period will be charged on the principal amount you had invested, you have taken, plus the interest amount which is due. So the same mechanism gets applied in both the cases. The only difference is the order of cash inflow and outflow. That's where the people get stuck. Some people would be like, sir, aapne to investment bola tha, to fir loan kaise aa gaya? Beta, whether it is a loan or an investment, you know, you just need to check that whether you are supposed to find the future value or you are supposed to find the present value. Accordingly, the formula will be applied. Right? So here you are finding the future value. So you need to do the process of compounding. Then there is a process of discounting. In discounting, the future value is given to you here. This amount is given to you. You are supposed to find the present value. And when you are supposed to find the present value, you follow the principles of discounting. This compounding and discounting is all about, that you will come to know within a very short period of time. Just giving you the brief idea right now for the conceptual clarity. So just giving you the example, say if you want 5 lakhs rupees after 5 years, this is also called as the goal-based planning, huh, my friends. Say you want 5 lakhs rupees after 5 years and you expect some interest rate, say 10% interest rate. Now, what amount you should invest now so that you will get 5 lakhs rupees after 5 years? So generally, the financial advisors who are doing the planning of the client follow this goal-based planning. First, you identify what is your goal. After some period of time, what amount you require? What is your rate of expectations? If your rate of expectations is too high in terms of interest, accordingly, you give the suggestions for the investment avenue, because some of the investment avenues are very safe and secured in nature, like the government bonds, fixed deposit. But sir, over there, return expectations is also quite low. But in some of the investment avenues, return expectations can be sky high, like direct investment into equity, stocks, shares. But there is a risk involved too much as well over there. So accordingly, based on the return expectations and the risk bearing capacity of the individual, we give the suggestions to the client related to the investment avenue. And then we come to know and we'll tell them that this is the amount you will have to invest now at this specified rate of return so that you will get 5 lakhs rupees after 5 years. So this is called as the process of discounting. In the easiest layman language, if you want to make a note of it, you can. The process of finding the future value from the present value is called as the compounding. The process of finding the present value from the future value is called as the discounting. Once that is crystal clear in your mind, I can move ahead to some practical exercises. May I have the confirmation from the students, please, that you are absolutely clear?
Yes, sir.
Thank you so much. My friend, this can further be interpreted from the loan perspective. Here I had told you that you require 5 lakhs rupees after 5 years. Let me just change the example. Say I am supposed to pay to Mr. Jossam 5 lakhs rupees after 5 years. Now, obviously, that amount is including the interest, whatever the interest that has been gathered for the 5 years. So what amount of loan I would have taken from Mr. Jossam so that I will be paying 5 lakhs rupees after 5 years, say at 8% interest rate charged on it. So it's basically the order of the cash inflow and outflow gets changed. Here in the loan, I would have received the amount first, and obviously then I would be making the payment to Mr. Jossam. But in case of investment, I was making the cash outflow first, and then I was receiving the money once the period and the tenure of investment gets over. Okay, let's move ahead to the questions. We are starting with very simple and easy questions. Slowly and steadily, we will increase our levels. धीरे धीरे लेवल को बढ़ाना है फिर हद से गुजर जाना है. लेट्स टेक द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन. आई होप एवरी वन वुड हैव टेकन द स्नैप ऑफ इट. मिस्टर विराट कोहली वॉन्ट्स टू इन्वेस्ट 10 करोड़ इन वन प्रोजेक्ट ऑफ क्रिएटिंग द चेन ऑफ जिम्नाशियम्स अक्रॉस द इंडिया. मिस्टर विराट कोहली हु इज नोन फॉर हिज एक्सट्रीम फिजिकल फिटनेस वॉन्ट्स टू बिल्ड द चेन ऑफ जिम्नाशियम्स अक्रॉस द इंडिया. He expects 12% return yearly from this gymnasium project? What will be the future value after 5 years? Suppose this is a compounding kind of a return he gets. So if you want to add it, you may just write it over here. What will be the future value after 5 years, considering the compounding return? For the better clarity, if you want to. Now you want to reach to the future value, sir. We have got the present value because obviously the investment is to be done today. So that we'll have the future value after some period of time. And this is just a single kind of the cash flow. There are various types of the cash flows when it comes to the compounding. You are investing only for the one time. Now, Mr. Virat Kohli would have invested on a yearly basis or on a quarterly basis or on a 6 monthly basis or on a monthly basis too. Now, if he is investing on a monthly basis or on some periodic basis, then it is called as the annuity. Annuity part will be covered later on. Right now, we are into the single cash flow. That means we are investing for the one period of time. The investment avenues for the single cash flows would be like the fixed deposits, some of the money you invest in national saving certificates issued by the Government of India, Kisan Vikas Patra. So various investment avenues are available to you where you are investing in the lump sum manner. Fixed deposits are the classic example of it. Okay. So the sir formula would be the future value equal to present value 1 plus r raised to n. Present value is multiplied by 1 plus r raised to n. 1 plus r raised to n is also called as the compounding factor. So you should be putting that in the back of your mind. So whenever from now onwards, if I'll say that what is the compounding factor, so you should be able to know that it's 1 plus r raised to n. Okay. So present value is the amount of investment he is making right now. That's going to be 10 crores. I'm just writing 10 crores. Do not make the mistakes in zeros. So those who are international students might not be very much familiar with the terminology of crores. But for a layman understanding, there are 8 zeros after one to be called it as the 10 crores multiplied by 1 plus r. Now r needs to be the periodic in nature. Now compounding is yearly or a 6 monthly or a monthly or whatever the compounding frequency is given to you. Here in this case, the compounding frequency is not given. They are not saying that interest is credited on a yearly basis or on a 6 monthly basis or on a quarterly basis. So we expect that it would be on a yearly basis only. So I'm just writing the rate, whatever that is, on a yearly basis. So 0.12, 12% can also be written in decimals as 0.12. Raised to after how many number of years he wants his money back? 5 years. So raised to 5. So first of all, I would be finding this compounding factor. 1.12 raised to 5. So what you will do in your calculator is that you will keep on multiplying it for 5 times. Please take your calculator out. 1.12 multiplied by 1.12, press equal to. Now 2 times has already happened, right? Because 2 times you have taken 1.12 multiplied by 1.12, press equal to. Now you'll be pressing the equal to for 3 more times, because 2 times are already taken. Once you press the equal to, then 3 more times you will press the equal to. So you will get some compounding factor in your calculator. Those who couldn't understand it, let me make it very clear again. 1.12 multiplied by 1.12, press equal to. So 2 times multiplication has happened. Now remaining 3 times are to be done. So now you will press on the same equal to equal to equal to three times. So that you get a compounding factor. May I have the answer from the students that what do you get as a compounding factor there? This kind of the small questions you may expect in the examination, because this can be solved in 30 seconds. You know, 1.12 raised to 5 is not something which will be taking too much of time of yours. So as far as the mid-semester one examination is concerned, our focus will be on the module number one and the time value portion, which is the part of the thing I have covered it up earlier, because I do not feel that it's a correct logical flow if we'll be covering it in the third module. It should be covered right in the initial stage. So time value of money plus the content of the first module. You can find the detailed content of the first module in your textbook, which I have uploaded, Prasanna Chandra. You may go through that. That is also called as the Gita, Bible, Quran of the financial management. Anyway, let me just give the answer of this compounding factor. 1.12 raised to 5, all of you. 1.7623. Thank you so much, Mr. Andrew, and all the people there. You may just unmute yourself whenever you want to convey your answer, because I'll not be able to see the chat box. 1.7623. You multiply that with 10 crores. How much you get? 17 crores, 62 lakhs, 30,000. That's going to be your future value after 5 years. Slowly and steadily, hadu hadu, we are starting with the very simple kind of questions. फिर आपको मालूम पड़ेगा कि सर ये कॉम्प्लिकेशंस कहां तक जा सकते हैं, लेकिन हमारा फाउंडेशन होना चाहिए बहुत स्ट्रॉन्ग, तभी जाके कॉम्प्लिकेशंस में जा सकते हैं। मिस दीपू वांट्स टू बाय अ मर्सिडीज कार आफ्टर 8 इयर्स फॉर हर फादर। नाउ मिस दीपू इज लविंग हर फादर अ लॉट, शी वांट्स टू बाय अ मर्सिडीज कार फॉर हिम आफ्टर 8 इयर्स, provided he would be alive. Obviously by God's grace he should be alive. She will invest 10 lakhs now for 8 years, compounded on a monthly basis at 15% expected rate of return. What amount she will have after 8 years? So the compounding frequency, my friends, is a monthly in nature. So accordingly, there would be few changes in our formula. The same formula will take place if we equal
to. Zoom?
Can you zoom?
No, sir. Can we do? Can we try?
You want to try? I didn't get your point. Can you just repeat it again? The voice is not getting properly.
Sir, I said, can we try, because this is quite similar with first one. Just one point is a difference.
Okay, can I try? Okay, fine. No worries. I'm trying it over here.
Yes,
in the
sure,
Excel.
Sir.
Okay. So equal to 1.12, Ms. Sethi, closing the bracket, raised to 5. So that rocket kinda sign, the rocket which you want to land to the Mars, you know, that's there above the 6 number ka key. You press that, that's the sign of equal to in the Excel. Raised to 5, so you get 1.7623. So these people who have got this answer are perfectly correct. Is it clear? Now I cannot show it to you by doing it in the calculator right now, you know. I'm not in the appropriate state of making myself visible in front of you. Okay. Clear, Ms. Sethi? All?
Yes, sir.
Good. Okay, let's move ahead. Sir, when the compounding frequency is different, at what time, what should we do? At that time, the rate must be divided by the compounding frequency. and number of periods must be multiplied by the compounding frequency. So the formula will remain same, FV equal to PV multiplied by 1 plus R raised to N. PV, she wants to invest right now in a one slot. It's the single cash flow, not an annuity. She wants to invest only for the one time. 10 lakhs multiplied by 1 plus R. Now, R has to be taken based on per month calculation. So we have got 15% per annum rate for the entire year to be divided by 12 months. Because my friend, there are 12 months in a year, right? So 0.15 to be divided by 12. In bracket, then raised to would be total number of years multiplied by the compounding frequency in a year. In a year, you have 12 months, right? So 12 must be multiplied by 8. So, 12 satta 84, 12 atta 96. So, there would be raised to power 96. Some people would be like, what is it? 12 atta 96. But we are Gujarati medium students, so we speak like this only. Okay, so it's nothing but just a calculation, you know. And that's been proven fact, actually. If you do the calculations in your mother tongue, your mind processes faster. And that's been also a scientifically proven fact that if you try to communicate in a different language, which is not your mother tongue, the mind takes the processing of 6 times of what you have been doing in your mother tongue. So for the calculations, I prefer this Gujarati medium things, you know, because we are habituated to do with this. Okay, let's move ahead. Raised to 96, and now people would be stuck. Then, sir, will be pressing this 96 on calculator, so that dhere 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 sham ho jayegi, hum so jayenge, to hum kya kare? There are ways. 10 lakhs multiplied by, first of all, give me this 0.15 divided by 12. What do you get there? Can someone just tell me? 0.15 divided by 12. Unmute yourself. I'm not able to see the chat box.
Sir, 0.0125.
0.0125, very good. To be there in a power 96. And now here at the MBA level, guys, MBA level, people use the PV and FP table. I am like, my students will be preparing the PV and FP table right in the Excel. I am not a fan of using these tables anywhere. Tables kaun use karega yaar? Multiplied by, now this 96, you will be applying a very, very basic mathematical theorem. The basic mathematical theorem is that whatever is there in a power, you take the same base. Then if you do the plus and addition of it, the power gets, you do the multiplication of this, the power gets added. So just giving you one example. So it's 1.0125 raised to 96, right? So how can I find 96? So 1.0125, if I put 20 over there, multiplied by 1.0125 multiplied by 20, power gets added. When we multiply the base, the same base, the power gets added. Multiplied by 1.0125 raised to 20, so 60 times is done. Multiplied by 1.0125 raised to 20, now 80 times done. The remaining times is 1.0125 raised to 16. 96 happened. You could have also taken 10. You take 9 times 10 raised to 10, you know. So you'll be finding the 10 only for the one time. Now, whatever the value you have got for raised to 10, you'll be substituting that value into this long equation that we have, friend. And whatever the compounding factor you get, you will just give it to me. So 20 times you can find, right? And if you're finding the difficulty in finding the 20 times, then my friends, you can do it 10 times too. So if you're doing it 10 times, then 1.0125 raised to 10, that you will do for How many number of times? 9 times. Then 90 would be done. And then only 1.0125 raised to 6 would be pending. So whatever the way that may be feasible to you, let's get it for 20 times. Then I'll be multiplying that for 4 times. And rest 16 times we'll be finding it again. So 1.10125 raised multiplied by 1.0125. So you press equal to. So do not forget that 2 multiplications has already happened. So rest 11 times you will have, rest 18 times you will have to do. So once you get the answer in equal to, no, you will press the equal to for 18 more number of times. So may I have the answer of the 20, please, all of you? Please calculate in your calculator and let me know. Mr. Neev is getting 3.296. Some people would be using the scientific calculator. As far as the guidelines in the examination are concerned, you can use the scientific calculator. There is absolutely nothing to be worried about, but you should be fundamentally clear about the mathematical things as well. You know, I don't have any problem with that. If you use the scientific calculator and if you have raised to power something, you directly multiply that, you get something, that's perfectly okay. So let me just verify that we have got the same answer, equal to 1.0125 raised to 96. So we have got 3.2955. Yes, a bit of an approximation will take place because you multiply it for many number of times. So approximation is going to occur. So 10 lakhs multiplied by 3.2955. So you multiply that, you get 32,95,500 rupees. Tell it to Deepu that you will not be able to buy the Mercedes car, and that too after 8 years. Right now it is costing somewhere around 40 to 50 lakhs starting from the very basic series. Okay, let's move ahead to the third question now. I have used the word miss. I think it should be misses to be factually correct. Mrs. Melinda Gates wants to invest 10 lakhs with 12% return expectations for 5 years, compounded on a continuous basis. What will be future value after 5 years? Okay, my friends. Now, when it comes to the periodic compounding, this formula is applicable. Periodic compounding, it can be daily, it can be monthly, it can be 6 monthly, it can be quarterly. So say if it is quarterly, then number of periods will be multiplied by 4, because in a year you have 4 quarters, right? And rate of return would be divided by 4, because in a year you have 4 quarters. Similarly, if the compounding frequency is semi-annual in nature, I'm using the word compounding frequency, that means your interest is credited on a periodic basis. That means on a semi-annual basis or a quarterly basis or something. So let me just give you an example of the semi-annual basis. Many of the people might be still stuck in some fundamentals. So say you are getting 10% on interest on 100 rupees. So my friend, you had invested 100 and 10% you are getting. So your fund value reaches to 110. Now this is a yearly compounding. 10% you have straight away got on yearly. On the next period, you get 10% on 110, so you get 11 rupees. And your fund value reaches to 121. Now, if it is a semi-annual in nature, then interest is credited on every 6 months. So if the interest is 10% for the entire year, then for the 6 months, obviously, it's going to be 5%, right? So 5% is credited for the first 6 months. So your fund value becomes 105 at the end of the first 6 months. Then 5% will again be they're on 105 for the next 6 months. So 5% on 105, I guess, would be 5.25. So your fund value reaches to 110.25 after the end of the first year. So when you follow the yearly compounding, your money will be 110. When you follow the semi-annual compounding, your money will be 110.25. So we can also put one more rule into the back of our mind, that higher the compounding frequency, better it is for you. So if your compounding frequency is quarterly, the interest would be even greater. So if the compounding frequency is monthly, the interest would be even greater. And if it would be daily, the interest would be even greater than that. Okay. But sir, when it is a continuous compounding, then what will happen? Now, what do we mean by continuous? Can someone tell me what do we mean by continuous compounding? Can you guess it, please, all of you? There is nothing mentioned. Yes, nothing mentioned. It's been mentioned like it's a continuous. Mr. Vishal is saying it's a daily. Okay. But in daily as well, you have 365 days, right, Mr. Vishal? Yes or no? So you can divide your rate by 365 and then you can multiply your number of periods by 365. Then also the things can happen, no? What do you mean by the continuous? Can anyone tell it? Yes, Miss Priska is. Yes, Miss Sethi, just a one. Miss Priska is saying there is absolutely no limit. Yes, you are absolutely correct. Yes, Miss Sethi, you may.
Sir, is it like whatever percentage we are getting in the first year, we will get interest on our present value and the first year interest rate? We will get more interest rate on, like, we will plus the present value and first year interest rate, then we will calculate next year interest rate. Is it compounding, sir?
Continuous? Slightly on the track, cannot be called entirely true. Mr. Jossam is saying reinvesting. Yes, Mr. Jossam, it's a reinvestment only. But reinvestment is happening on a continuous basis. What do you understand by the continuous? Some people would be like, sir, it's daily. Now, see, even a day can be bifurcated into various parts, right? You can have the 24 number of hours in a day. So you can multiply your N with the number of hours and you can divide your rate by number of hours in a year, right? Then if someone would be too scientific, you would be like, sir, hours can also be further divided into seconds. So number of seconds in a year will be multiplied by N in a raised to power, and R would be divided by number of seconds in a year. Scientists, they would be like, sir, even the seconds can be further divided into microseconds. Because there is no time horizon which is continuous in nature. Everything we have decided into parts just for our better conceptual clarity and just for our, you know, basic needs and things. But continuous means it never stops. It's a never ending, limitless process. So what happens basically, we'll be using the concept of limit now. You must have studied the limits in somewhere in your school. Now let me just brief you about the limits. Say you divide your entire year into 6 months, right? Here you have first 6 months, here you have second 6 months. Then my friend, this can be further divided into quarter, right? So one quarter, second quarter. Then there is a this period. So one quarter can further be divided into 3 months, right? So months can further be divided into daily. Day can further be divided into hours, seconds, and microseconds. That means I can say that my number of periods are infinite. Number of periods are infinite, but they are bound by a one specific amount of money after 5 years, right? Miss Melinda gets once her money back after how many number of years? 5 years. Now there is no need for her to invest right now, you know, because she would have already got some amount of money. Do you know who is the richest woman in the world? She is the ex-wife of Jeff Bezos, and she got her entire money from the marriage divorce alimony. That's not the right way to get rich. Anyway, she has the right to get the money as well. I'm not criticizing that. So what I'm trying to say, my friend, is continuous is something which cannot be defined. It is infinite in nature. Infinite. So when it is infinite in nature, that means I can say that my number of periods are ever increasing, you know. So say if this is my number of periods and this is my year. So first it can be 6 months, then it can be quarter, then it can be month, then it can be daily, then it can be seconds, then it can be microseconds. It would be. This is the exponential curve. That means number of periods are infinite, ever increasing. Each and every addition is greater than the previous addition. Number of periods are infinite in nature. My friends, if number of periods are infinite in nature, we follow the formula of the continuous compounding. These people have decided this. These people have derived the formula of the continuous compounding, PV multiplied by e raised to RT. E stands for the exponential function. Exponential function or exponential factor as well, some people regard it. Raised to RT. R stands for the rate of return. T stands for the number of years after which we require the money. E raised to RT. Now, what is the value of E? E stands for the exponential function. So, whenever something is increasing exponentially, that means the new addition is greater than the previous addition. That's called as the exponential growth. Now, that can further be found by, you know, doing this calculation. So you started with, say, one factorial. Then you divide one divided by one factorial. Then you add one divided by two factorial. Then you add one divided by three factorial. So these are, say, the number of periods are getting added on a continuous basis, you know. So factorial means whatever the value you have after that, you multiply that by that value. So 2 multiplied by 1, so that is 2 factorial. 3 factorial means 3 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 1. Then you keep on adding it for the infinite number of times, you know. So 4 factorial. So here 4 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 1. And that you keep on dividing by 1. So if you do it for infinite number of times, no, then you reach to the value called 2.718. Because see, first we are dividing into 6 months, then 6 months are further divided into quarters, then quarters are further divided into days, then days are into months, days are into, sorry, hours, hours are into seconds. So number of periods are continuously ever increasing. So we are using the concept called factorial, which is again ever increasing in nature. In the denomination, you know. So you reaches to the value called 2.718. So this is how we have derived the value of 2.718. So the calculation of the 2.718 is this factorial methodology that we have followed. So those who couldn't understand it, there is no complications in it. You will have to just remember the value of the exponential factor. Sometimes it may be given to you in the examination if the tutor is, you know, a good. But if the tutor will not be a good and he wants to test your intellect, he might not give you this value of the exponential factor. But we people are aware about it, 2.718. Because after some extent, 1 divided by 5 factorial, 6 factorial will be putting a very less amount of addition, you know. Because when the denomination increases to the great extent, then the increasing addition would be quite slow, quite less. So ultimately, if you do it for the infinite number of times, no, you'll be reaching to 2.718 only. So it's just like the pi value we have got, 22 by 7, 3.14. Similarly, we have got the value of the exponential function as well. That's 2.718. I have also explained you the mathematics behind it. Okay. So this is the formula PV multiplied by e raised to RT. And that will be solving in the next lecture, because we also be requiring the log table for this if you do not have the scientific calculator. So if you do not have the scientific calculator, that's perfectly fine. Okay. We'll be using the log table. I'll be circulating the log table to you before the next session. That's it from my side as far as this day is concerned. May I have the confirmation from the students that you are absolutely clear with everything we have discussed till now, all of you? Good. Absolutely. Mr. Emmanuel, do not get confused with the perpetual. That's a little bit different. I'll tell you the meaning of perpetual after some time. Good. So I have received confirmation from the various students. Good to see. Those who couldn't get it, you will have to just remember the formula of the exponential factor when it's a continuous compounding in nature. So that's it from my side for the day. Please put your enrollment number as a mark of your attendance. Bye-bye. Take care. Sayonara. Enjoy the rest of the day. See you all in the next session. Do not forget to put your attendance, please. Please mark your attendance correctly. Your enrollment number should be mentioned correctly, and you should be mentioning your own enrollment number, not of someone else.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much to you as well. Take care. Thank you.